In this video, we're going to take a look at how to use a client script to pre-fill a subform. And this is useful for various reasons. You can basically put in the needed information already and allow the user to then go and make edits, delete what they don't need. We're going to be using this in our proposal module today, and this is just a brief look at that. So let's get into this. A few things that we're going to need. We're going to need one, the API names, and this is in our proposals module. This is looking at the subform. The subform is called statement of work, and so we have the different fields here. Then I'm going to be grabbing stuff from the proposal items and putting that into the client script. And so here's the base breakdown of the proposal module. You can see the statement of work, and here's the various fields that we want to fill in and when it's loading. And so going to create the going to create this here, and it's going to be on the create page. The module is proposals. The layout name is new. It's going to be on load. And so basically we want to be able to take this, and as soon as they load to start a new proposal, these items are going to fill into the subform. And I'm just going to give just a couple here. We have a lot more that we're going to put in based on different criteria, but you'll get a chance to see how we did this. So starting off using the ID of one of the records. So, and you get that ID here from the proposal module. Reason being is that this field here, task name, is a lookup field. So we need both the ID and the name of the field. And so the ID is here, and then the name of it is here. And so I'm just hard posting these in here. The ID, the name, the option I got from here. The description I just copied and pasted from here. And then we create the collection. This is what we're going to be pushing our information into. So basically, if you think about it, if you've used custom functions in Deluge to make subforms, you have to do a map, and that contains the field names, and then you put to those, and then you add each map to a list, and then that list is what then finally gets put into the subform when you're updating, so into the overall map for the record. But in this case, we just have to make the collection. And so I typically like to do make sure that I am doing the fields as they appear. They don't have to be in order like that. It will realize it, but it's just easier to keep track and to make sure I'm getting the right information in. And so subform row is our name of our collection, and we're going to be pushing the values into it. And so you start off with a pair of parentheses. With inside, you put a pair of squiggly brackets, and then you can start putting in your fields. And so this is the field name. This is the API field name that found right here. So if I'm looking at the option, that's where I'm going. And then this option is the variable up here that we named it, and so forth. So then you have the next field. Then for the lookup field, it's a little different. You put the lookup name, okay, here from, we can see here, it is our task one. It's our lookup. And so with that, you put it, and then you put another set of squiggly brackets. You put the ID, and then, of course, the ID of the record, and then the name of the record comes from that variable. Then you finish off, and these extra fields, unit quality and quantity, these numbers I did get from these two fields here and just put them in. And so once you push, then you can do more. So you can do multiple rows, however many you need to fill in. So I'm just doing two. Here again, put in the different information. And then finally, when you're done and you have all the information that you want to put in it, then the last statement is to get the field in this service list. This is the API name for statement of work. So I see statement of work here. I come back up here, find statement of work, and there's my API name. It's service list. And now I'm going to set the value, and I'm going to use the subform row. That is our collection. So when I go to run this, you're going to see I have two rows of information that were pushed in. And like I said, you can put as many in there as you want. And depending on the type of information you're wanting to put there, because our proposal items module is a custom module, not all custom modules are recognized in the script. And that's why I'm having to hard code them. But ones that are, instead of these, I would actually, instead of hard coding them, I would be putting in basically like the get field and then getting the value and then putting that into it. But because our module is not being recognized by the client script, I had to hard code everything. But this is an effective tool. You can use it to not only, I mean, you can preform a lot of different fields, validate, as you can see in some of our other videos, but this one with subform is a little bit different way to do it, but it is a neat tool. And hope you enjoyed this. Have a great day.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.